Hello all, this is Mohammad Hanif from RGKT Basar. Welcomes you once again to this lab session on subject digital signal processing. Today we will be working on FIR high pass filter. Okay, so for this one I recommend you to go through my previous video on the designing how we have designed a low pass filter in MATLAB. So using the same code, by making some small changes in that code, we can generate a high pass filter today. Okay, so I request you to go through my previous video on low pass filter. Okay, so first we'll be working the same code for a low pass filter. So this is the code which we have written for low pass filter earlier. So I will be running the same code once, and then we'll use the same code, and then we'll try to design today high pass filter. Okay, so running this program, so it is asking for enter the sampling frequency, so going with 8000, and then it is asking for the analog cutoff frequency. Okay, so here I am giving a 3000 as a cutoff frequency. So this cutoff frequency shall not be more than half of this sampling frequency. So here sampling frequency, as we are giving 8000, that means we are allowed to go up to 4000 only. So here I am taking 3000, which is legally allowed. Okay, so now entering this, now it is asking for the window size. So as earlier we have given 51, so I am going with the same 51 here. So this will be the impulse response for low pass filter, and for the size of 51 samples. Okay, next this will be the you can see that this is a low pass filter designing, right? Now here you can see that the frequency it allowed up to maximum 3000, so that is what we have given as a cutoff frequency. Okay, now in this program we have seen that we need to generate two signals, namely X1 and X2. So it is asking for the frequency of X1. So I am giving here 500, and another I am giving more than cutoff frequency. So the cutoff frequency was 3000, so I am giving 3500, right? So here you can see that this is the X1 signal, and low pass filter for this signal also we have written in the code. So this is your low pass filter response for this one, and then this is 3500 signal, and you can see that here if you do the low pass filter for this one, the signal response, you can see that the amplitude of this one has been reduced, and then we have taken this X1 and X2 and we summed those two signals and made as a X, and then you can see that the low pass filter frequency of this X1 plus X2 is this one, which is the same frequency as X1. Okay, I hope you have clear with this one. Now we'll be writing the program for high pass filter. Okay, closing all these windows. So here we have to remind one more thing, how we can convert the low pass filter to high pass filter. For that one we'll be using the formula. Okay, conversion technique. So I am writing that formula here. H. It will be given as, we have to multiply minus 1 over n with, this is the multiplication symbol, we have to multiply this one with filter coefficients of low pass filter. That's it. So we have to remember this formula. Using this conversion technique, we can now convert our low pass filter written code into high pass filter. Okay, so starting with the same thing, so CLC, clear all, close all will remain same. So it is asking for enter the sampling frequency. Okay, so I'll let me copy this. We'll copy the entire code and then we'll paste in new one. Okay. Whenever we need some changes, we will make those changes. Okay. So here it is asking sampling frequency, and then TS is 1/FS. This is will be the sampling period, and then it is F cutoff frequency. So instead of FC, here we will try to write, okay, high pass filter, and then this is analog cutoff frequency. So for digital cutoff frequency, it would be FCH. Okay. So this is equivalent digital cutoff frequency. And then, so as we are interested to write program first in low pass filter and then converting into high pass filter, so we need one low pass filter cutoff frequency also. So that we'll write as like this. It will be pi minus omega c h. So this is conversion of high pass filter to low pass. So this is not conversion, this is equivalent digital cutoff frequency in for LPF. Okay, it will be for low pass filter, right? And then this will be remain same here. This will be filter coefficient. This is for filter coefficients. Right. And C we are using as per center of the window. Center of the window. And then here we will be writing that low pass filter for impulse response of low pass filter, and we are assigning it to filter coefficient. So this is sine omega n by pi n. Okay, and then continuing the same program. So this is using symmetry property. Those who are watching this video for the first time, I request you to go through the previous video where I have explained in detail this one. Okay, so next we will be design here. It will be we are figuring here we'll be plotting the this high pass filter response for this one. So this will be casual impulse response of not LPF. It will be high pass filter, right? And then once again we are converting into a discrete Fourier transform. So same thing. So it will be high pass filter, and okay, so here we have to make one small change. That change will be this one we have to include in our program like this one, otherwise we'll be getting the same low pass filter. So here we have to write this one. So after this H, so earlier H impulse response is consisting of low pass filter. Now we have to convert that into high pass filter. So we have to write, right? We'll be writing this. So H minus 1 and power n minus. So as we are using here in some steps in window size, so we have to write that one plus 1. Okay, and then we have to multiply this one with previous H. Okay, so this is our conversion of LPF into SPF. Okay, then so we'll be taking one figure and plotting this one. So taking with stem and plotting this label by label, and then taking another figure and drawing the magnitude response of this one, and then digital frequency we have converted into digital, and then DTFT of that filter as SPF, and then converting in equivalent HPF. Okay, so here we are going to get figure one. In figure one, we are going to get the impulse response. In figure two, we are going to get three plots. So that's why here it is written here 3, 1, 1. Okay, and then next we are generating signals. So first we are taking NTS, so 0 to TS and 1 TS. Okay, and then taking two signals, frequencies F1 and F2. Okay, and then designing those using with those F1 and F2, we are designing two different signals, X1 and X2. And then we are summing up those two signals into X. I am taking Y1 and Y2 Y as a variables for this will be after convolution. That means Y1, Y2, Y will be having the filter outputs. Okay, so Y1 will be, it is a filter output of X1, Y2 will be the filter output of X2, and then similarly Y1 will be assigned for X. Okay, so here doing the main, this is for convolution. Okay, similarly this is also for convolution, and this is also for convolution operation we are performing on impulse response of a high pass filter with our signals X1, and here we are doing with X2. So that's why I have told you that Y1 will be having the filter output of X1. Similarly, Y2 will be having the filter output of X2, and then Y will be having the sum of these two signals X1 and X2. And taking another figure, so here we'll be making a six plots will be there. So for that one, we are taking a subplot of 3, 2, 1. So that means 3 rows and 2 columns. And then first we are here designing input signal X1. And then in second plot, we'll be making Y1, that is the output of, that is the output of X1. And next taking X2 signal and then Y2. So this is not LPF, this will be high pass of input signal, right? And this will be high pass filter response of input signal. Then taking X, which is a combination of two signals X1 and X2, and this will be our high pass. So that's it. I hope you have understand this coding. Wherever we need, just we did only small changes. The first change is here, taking equivalent digital cutoff frequency from defined high pass filter. So this will be equivalent digital cutoff frequency for HPF. Okay, and from this we have defined omega C for low pass filter. And then one more change what we have done is here in this step, converting the impulse response of low pass filter into high pass filter. So only one change we have done here. Using this change only we can generate the high pass filter. Okay, now running the code. So before it is asking to save, so saving the program, FIR HPF filter, right? So asking for sampling frequency, once again going with 8000. The maximum allowed frequency will be 4000 as a cutoff frequency. So here we are giving 2000 as a cutoff frequency, and the window size, so 51. You can see that this is the impulse response for impulse response will be this. The impulse response of high pass filter is like this. Okay, and then this is our filter designing. So here you can see that the cutoff frequency is, allowed cutoff frequency will be 2000. Okay, that means if we give any signal frequency less than 2000, that will be having a less amplitude or it will be suppressed. And if the signal frequency is more than 2000 and in between up to or 4000, it would be allowed. Okay. So now here it is asking the signal X1. So let's we'll give 500, and then we'll give 3000 here. So these are the outputs. Now you can see that this is the first signal 500 frequency of FR X1. Now you can see that amplitude is 1 here, but after filtering, you can see that it is the gain of this first signal is drastically reduced and it is given 0.01. That means this is filter output. It is not allowing because the cutoff frequency is 2500 and 5000 is 500 is less than that one. So that's why we got high pass filter. And this is second signal. The frequency is 3000. And then you can see that magnitude is 1. And even in output of that after filtering, the magnitude is also 1 here. And then we have combined the two signals X1 plus X2. And then this is one model after combining these two signals. And after doing the filter on this one, you can see that these two signals are same. So we have filtered successfully X1 signal and then we have retained X2 as it is. Okay. I hope this is clear. The only thing is we have to be first we have written program for the low pass filter and then we have converted. Only small changes is that by making this cutoff frequency for low pass filter, defining the cutoff frequency for low pass filter and writing impulse response for low pass to high pass will give you high pass filter. Okay. I hope this is clear. Thank you.